H.L. Mencken called the martini the only American invention as perfect as the sonnet. And that has really stuck with me because, oh wait, I suck at research. The martini is one of the most misunderstood guns in the game. Most people compare the stats of the martini with the sparks and see the martini as the lesser version. But those people are looking at it wrong, and I will explain how. But first, I want to give an overview of the Martini-Henry and all of its variants. But keep this in mind. The Martini values simplicity and power. So, the Martini is a long ammo 3-slot rifle. It costs $122, does 143 damage to the torso within 10 meters, and has an effective range of 334 meters. And that will come back later. The Martini has four variants: the base Martini, the Deadeye, the Marksman, and the Riposte. The Martini has three special ammo types: explosive, FMJ, and incendiary. I don't recommend you use any of these, and we will talk about why later in the video. So, players might look at a few of the statistics on the Sparks and say that it is obviously better. The Sparks does 4% more damage, has a 4% longer effective range, has 4% better handling, and most often discussed, a 25% faster muzzle velocity, which means Sparks users need to lead shots less. And do we really care about one extra second on a reload anyway? And many people agree with this analysis and dismiss everything else about the Henry that gives it an edge in most gunfights. The Martini has three critical advantages over the Sparks: reserve ammo, reload speed, and related to that, rate of fire. The Martini comes with 21 bullets, the most of any of the long ammo guns. The Sparks only has 17. Sure, you can get more ammo, but that's not a comfort when no ammo is around. And with 4 extra bullets, the Martini can last longer without needing an ammo box. This also means that, all factors the same on ammo alone, the Martini-Henry can afford to take more shots in a gunfight and still be in a similar situation compared to the Sparks. Don't worry, my argument doesn't rest on 4 extra bullets. We also need to look at reload and rate of fire. The Martini has a 3-second reload versus the Sparks' 4-second reload. Is 1 second a big deal? No. But how many trio teams have you killed with one bullet? Both of these are breech-loading rifles, so the playing field is the same. The more you shoot, the more those seconds add up, which brings us to rate of fire. The practical application of the reload speed is that the Martini can fire every 3 seconds, the Sparks every 4. That means in 60 seconds, a Martini can potentially fire 20 shots, while the Sparks can only fire 15. True, no one is shooting this much this fast, but even in the span of 10 seconds, a Martini can get off 3 shots, while the Sparks is halfway through the third reload. How many times have you died wishing you could have fired one more shot? So on ammo, reload speed, and fire rate, the Martini performs better in a gunfight. But these are both long ammo rifles. This isn't like the comparison to the Springfield, which is medium ammo. These guns hold their damage over range the exact same way, but the amount of damage is different. So what does that look like? This chart is the damage drop-off for long ammo that the devs posted for the 1.6 update. I will also link it in the description below. Okay, and these are those numbers applied to the Martini and the Sparks. The base damage of both drops off at the same rate, but the higher damage of the Sparks means in extreme ranges, like in the 400 meter mark, the Sparks needs to fire one less shot than the Martini. But if you are within 200 meters of your target, which is most gunfights, you would be better served by the Martini if you learn to compensate for the slower muzzle velocity. Yes, this takes practice, but you have the extra ammo and fire rate to do just that. So, I don't want this video to go on forever, but if you enjoy sniping at super long ranges, sure, take the Sparks, it's a better pick. But if you are in the usual team scuffles, the Martini is a great gun to put your enemies on the back foot. You can tag enemies faster, take more shots through walls, risk missing more, and find more ammo less often compared to using the Sparks. And remember, the Martini favors simplicity. Should you take special ammo with it? No, probably not. Explosive ammo sucks at killing enemy hunters. FMJ makes the bullet velocity worse, and that's already one of the biggest hurdles, and fire ammo just isn't necessary. But because the Martini favors simplicity, the variants are just as easy to pick up. The Riposte offers players a 168 damage bayonet charge. The Deadeye version is very effective in medium and long range, if you can learn to lead, and the Marksman version isn't ideal for sniping given its bullet velocity, but it can be used for it if you want that quicker reload. So, 3 and 4 stars, hear me now, especially if you struggle with the sparks. Before you buy the Sparchy for the umpteenth time, and die in a single compound fight where you don't need that range and muzzle velocity at all, consider that using the Martini makes you no less of a marksman. Take the gun that lets you hide your mistakes and experiment with a little penetration. Even if you aren't nailing headshots, you can contribute to your team more by tagging enemies, suppressing hunters, and generally getting more shots downrange than with the sparks. So go be the most martini-loving, wall-banging, 007-esque hunter in the bayou, and leave the sparks at home. Your team will thank you for it.